So what do you think is the hardest part about filmmaking?
There is none. It's a myth. There's one thing that's complicated in life is brain surgery. Or build spaceship. Or build plane that stand in the air. You know, every time you're in the airplane, you're like, how are we flying in the first place? Because this is a heavy piece of equipment. I mean, really, if you think about it. So anything that's not brain surgery or space technology is easy. There's that a lot of people used to, and that's why we have to be extremely thankful to the digital, to the Mark Zuckerberg, to all these young people who have developed those, to all the people who have developed the hardware. There is no, it's a total myth. Unfortunately, Hollywood's still extremely, what's the good word? That wouldn't offend anybody. Okay, so we work very hard in trying to break those barriers, and there's nothing worse. You, each one of you should have your own YouTube account, even if you only have one video that introduce yourself to the market with what you want to do. Well, Film, I know you have a multimedia department, that could be an assignment. When you send to prospective employers, there's nothing complicated about film. They're trying to make you believe it's complicated so you don't get in the game. But that's very easy. This camera costs $20. The SD card costs $20. For 120, and this costs $300 altogether. You can do films with this now. So don't let them bamboozle you in believing it's that. It's hard. It's not hard. Yes.
What's your Twitter name?
Oh, GZIP USA, which stands for Ground Zero Incubation Project.
GZ, say that one more time.
GZIP USA.
Because I got to follow you. You think you follow me?
Yes.
That you can, you know, get in touch with people like this. Deepak or whoever, my husband follows Deepak, but also has, you know, got reached out to people through Twitter. I mean, we are living in a really exciting age where you can do that kind of thing.
I just wanted to say quickly that I came primarily for the previous thing on the certification, and I was like, oh, I don't know if I have the time to say, I'm so happy I stayed. You're both of you ladies were fantastic.
Oh.
I learned a lot, and it was so entertaining. It was great.
This question is from Annie's general store. You spoke about social media and blogs and, you know, Facebook. I just wanted to know, what is the success rate of social media in terms of attracting customers as opposed to the traditional marketing methods?
That's an interesting point. She is saying, what are the success rates of social media versus traditional marketing? And that's, I think when you ask, I was just reading the New York Enterprise Report, there was a survey about that, about how many business owners really thought that they were getting, you know, return on their investment. And, you know, you really have to be able to track where the sales are coming from, or track where your how much is actually going into sales. So for me, I can see, again, through the Google Analytics and the tracking that are through the blog, I can see where people are coming from. But it's really a lot more obvious when a blog is writing about us and we can see the path that they're taking to find our website. So it can be a lot of time that you put into it without like a specific return on investment, but you can have different codes. If you're selling something, you can put a different code that would be on Facebook versus a code that they can get from a blog and that kind of thing to track that way. So it can be a lot of time and not that much return.
So do you think you were successful in attracting people through social media, or it was more like word of mouth or
We actually, speaking of traditional marketing, we don't. I just was on a phone call for a case study about marketing, and she said, "Oh, so you don't do any traditional marketing?" I'm like, "What is it? I don't even. It's hard to even define what traditional marketing is right now. I mean, we have a newsletter that goes out through email, but have I ever like printed out a newsletter? I mean, do people still do that? I can't imagine. Sorry if that's what's going on in the world.
Did you
What's that?
Do you go to industry shows?
Like trade shows?
Yes.
We go to trade shows to buy product.
Yeah.
But those are the kind of trade shows that we attend.
Just to buy them.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, I guess two more questions and you were...
Yeah. The question I have is, both of you mentioned that you have help from family members and friends starting you out in social media and so on. But for a prospective business owner, somebody who want to start out and start going on social media, what approach do you recommend for them to take? Do you recommend them going to a outside company to do the promotion, set up their website and so on, or their accounts? Or do you recommend them trying to do it themselves? Or, you know, you have some companies that promote like, oh, do your own website and so on, but some people use that. And it could create a bad website where, you know, it could turn people off from their company, so mess up the overall effort that they're trying to do. So what's your recommendation for someone that's actually starting out through social media?
Well, I'll just really quickly say, I started my own blog. It took like 5 minutes, but I wanted to then enhance it. They're free. I have mine on WordPress, wordpress.org. It can walk you through it. They have like 50 different backgrounds you can use. I wanted to customize mine. I asked my web team, I told them what I wanted to do. They charged me, you know, $100 to customize it. It can be fairly simple to do. I would just Google, you know, I look on the different platforms that you're trying to accommodate. And then there's also a lot of frequently asked questions, that kind of thing that people can help you with. I think it's a lot simpler. I don't think you should have to hire somebody to do it.
I just want to tell something. There is a lot of, their generation is the first generation totally raised with computers. We were the generation who created it. So they all, wouldn't you work for $100 and help companies to do it? You have to tap into the youth. They do it in their sleep. So what they do. My daughter programs everything for me and she's like, Mommy, it's easy. You click here, you click here, you do this. Tap in the youth. You can go to any university you have and ask for the Department of Multimedia and you can give them, you know, $100 a week, which is not that much, but it's not free labor. And they'll do it. That's what they do, and that's what you should go, because they will be dedicated, they will love to be able to work, it'll be on their resume, and they will help you forever. And they'll forever be thankful that you hired them.
Okay, I had just one more.
Yeah. I was just wondering how you have plans for growth, like for in specific reference to you too, Annie. How do you handle increased demands for product and even just staffing and all these kinds of things? Have you planned for that?
Well, interesting question. First of all, two parts. We're getting ready for holiday, which is our biggest time of the year. We're going to have 7 placements in national magazines, which is going to be crazy for our online store. We also have a pop-up shop that's going to be in Greenwich, Connecticut. So for the holidays, we really ramp up our presence, and we hire a lot of seasonal help, a team that we really keep in touch with all year round in order to keep them interested and everything like that. But overall, the reason that I'm here today is because I'm also part of a program called Strategic Steps for Growth, which Tanya Pope and Ophelia are part of over here, and that is to create a 3-to-5-year action plan that we're going to present in January. So honestly, I work on that every day. I think about it every time we have a class. I have a completely new idea about where I want to take our store. In July, our store will have been open for 5 years, and our lease is up. So I'm just thinking about a ton of different ways to expand it. So you can join our newsletter and learn more.
Okay, thank you so much. We're running a little bit late. So. We have just a short break, 3 to 5 minutes.